What if there was a way to go solar that didn't require you to mount 2,000 pounds worth of batteries on your wall, didn't require you to lose any space inside of your house or garage, and give you an easy to service, safe, and aesthetic way to store your solar gear? Well, with room for up to 43 kilowatt hours of battery and 32 kilowatts of inverter output, EG4's BossBox is meant to house more power than most homes probably need. And this right here might just be the best thing that you didn't know you needed. So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. Earlier this year, Tiny Baby and I took a trip down to Texas, and while we were there, we stopped in at Signature Solar and shook hands with some of the people that we actually recommend you guys to shop with in all of our videos. Turns out they're running a pretty legit operation down there. When we were there, we saw a BossBox in their parking lot. It was set up with like a solar EV charger they had going on so their employees could charge their cars. And we thought that the BossBox was the coolest thing at the time. Fast forward a little bit and we have gotten our hands on our very own BossBox. We've had it here at the lab for a little while now. And while it's not all sunshine and rainbows, we feel that we are ready to share our experience with the BossBox with you guys. As always, we have links in the description down below to any products that we talk about. We also have any coupons that we can get out of Signature Solar to save you guys some money. We'll leave links to both the BossBox and like the inverters and batteries and stuff that we talk about today. Before we jump into our experience, we're gonna hit you guys with a super quick teardown in case you're not already familiar with the BossBox. First up, this thing does not pass the Tiny Baby lift test. It weighs just under 400 pounds. It's easy enough to lift if you have a couple hands. Everybody can kind of squat it and move it around. Not too bad, but Tiny Baby all by himself, no bueno. So basically, the BossBox is an energy storage enclosure. It's a weatherproof, I guess, area for you to store batteries and mount your inverters on the outside. It's made of epoxy coated steel, so it should last a really long time and it shouldn't rust. And it's perfect for setups where maybe you don't have a lot of room to store your equipment inside, or maybe you don't even own the place you're trying to mount it, so mounting on a wall is not an option altogether. It has two access doors, both on the front and on the rear. It has vents that you can choose if you want to mount them on one side or the other. That side would become the front, and it also has vents on the roof. Its design is actually pretty clever. You're able to get a pallet jack or like a forklift or something in there. So even if you had it full of batteries and inverters, you can still pick it up and move it around if you had the right equipment. In terms of compatibility, this thing works with up to two 12K PVs, 18K PVs, the FlexBoss 18 and the FlexBoss 21. And in terms of batteries, it works only with their all-weather battery with the adjustable feet, which I think we were told by them that every battery from the time of this video on is gonna be sold with adjustable feet. And like we said, it can hold up to two inverters and up to three batteries at once. They recommend you put it on like a concrete foundation or somewhere pretty stable because it's gonna be about 2,000 pounds of weight once you have it all set up. So you don't wanna put it on a unstable surface. And right now, at the time of filming this video, with our discount code, the BossBox is $2,499, which is a lot. The first thing that we like about the BossBox was the assembly was very easy and honestly didn't take super long. The components were really simple and they went together really easy. When you build it though, you do need to use the batteries as structural support. So we recommend you build it where you want it. You don't do what we did, which was build it for demonstration and then realize we don't actually want it there. We have to take it all back apart just to move it to another location. We also like that this thing can be moved with a forklift if you had access to one. So if you were using this in more of an industrial setup, or if you were using this more as like a mobile thing in replace of like a generator, you could leave it fully assembled, pick it up with the batteries and everything inside and move it around, which is cool, especially on the installer side of things. If they have a forklift, they can build it wherever and then just move it to where it's gotta be instead of having to assemble it in a really awkward location. It's also pretty cool that you can use the 12K, the 18K and the FlexBoss 18 and 21 systems in any combination. So you don't just have to have this wired where it's like a three battery system with one or two inverters. Theoretically, you can play any kind of games that you want. You could have one inverter on one side tied to one battery with another inverter on the other side tied to two batteries. And you can really set this up however you want, however fits your needs, and with whatever inverters you may already have, as long as they're compatible. It's also got nice locking doors. So no matter where you put this thing, you can keep the peeping toms away, keep it safe from your kids or your neighbors or whatever. And overall, it just looks professional and it's well built. A lot of people have like a Generac beside their house, or you have like a big massive power box in your literal front yard. This looks like those things, but it looks a lot cleaner and a lot more approachable. It's built pretty well. The vents, you can move them for like the front or the back doors. A lot of people who may be using this in like an off-grid situation, whether that's like a small home or even a whole home, you might want to be building somewhere to store your batteries and inverter anyways. Same thing that Dylan did with his cabin. So he had to build a whole little outbuilding to put the batteries and the inverters. Josh did the same thing with his tiny home. He built a whole little building for his generator. So people are already out there building little buildings to put their stuff inside of. This looks way cleaner, way more professional, and it's actually got a warranty involved with it. Easy to service and easy to set up, and it makes a lot of sense. Like, it's something that I personally would rather have this in my yard somewhere in the corner or whatever than put all the batteries and inverters and stuff in my garage and lose that space. It is not all perfect though, and the couple things that we don't like are gonna start with, there was a couple manufacturing defects. The wall dividers that the batteries bolt onto, one of them actually, the bolt holes didn't line up with the holes in the floor. So when we were assembling it, one side the screws bolted in, the other side the screw holes didn't line up at all. Small little thing, but it's frustrating when you're trying to assemble it and you're halted because the holes don't line up. And we also had a dent in our roof panel when it shipped. It was just kind of on the top of the pallet. It wasn't really supported very well. It'd be pretty easy for like heavy things that are getting shipped in that same truck or whatever to go ahead and dent that roof panel. We were able to pop our dent out. There's a secondary little dent above the vents. Not the end of the world, but it is a buzzkill if you pay a lot of money for something like this to show up and it's a little damaged. This box, it's meant to be outdoors. That's the whole point. And it works with the all-weather batteries, and the all-weather batteries are meant to be outdoors. Same with the inverters. All of this stuff is rated to be outside. But in our opinion, EG4 could have included like a little rubber seal around the doors. We had this thing outside in some rain. We sprayed a hose on it to simulate some way worse rain. And we found that no matter what was going on outdoors, water kind of seeps in around the door. And it, when you open the doors, it's all wet in the bottom where the batteries go, which isn't the worst thing in the world, but it'd just be nice if, since you're paying all this money for this thing, when you open it, it was dry inside and it was just breathing, not building humidity and whatever. Another thing that we found a little annoying was we actually couldn't properly install this because our all-weather batteries from EG4 are the old version. As of the time of this video, every outdoor all-weather battery that EG4 sells is gonna come with screw-in feet. Basically, when you hang the battery on the wall, you need to screw the feet down to add like rigidity to the whole unit. Ours is an older version of the outdoor battery and it just has little rubber feet that you can't thread down. So when you hang the battery on the wall, it actually adds a lot of weight and the whole thing wants to kind of tip over. There's no way to put screw-in feet on our batteries. So if you already had these batteries, you can't just throw them in this system properly. But any batteries EG4 sells going forward, they have told us, are gonna come with the screw-in feet so they will properly work with the BossBox. And finally, the battery cables that come with the batteries are not big enough to set up inside of this unit. So longer battery cables as some sort of package would be pretty cool. If you go ahead and buy the batteries and then you go ahead and buy the BossBox, you're gonna also need to buy bigger cables. The cables that come with these batteries to reach the inverters are not meant to run up off the battery, down through, and then back up into the inverter. There's just not enough length there. So we had to go ahead and pay extra for extra cables. It would be cool if you could get some sort of package on their website that allowed you to skip that. So who is this for? If you're looking to store your equipment outside and you were already gonna invest in building some sort of shelter to do so, this is a perfect solution for you because not only does it work right now, but if you ever move, you can literally pick this thing up and move it with you. You don't have to leave that structure behind and build a new one wherever you're going. It's also cool for someone that's traveling, maybe for like event power. You wanna load this thing up and put it on a trailer or in a big truck. You show up to your event, run it, and then leave with it. You can't just pick it up, but like if you had the right equipment, it is portable. So it's like having a big ass generator that you can bring around with you. It's also good for someone who maybe wants to go solar and literally just cannot where they are. Like maybe you don't own the place that you are at and you want to put everything outside and just run it in. Or like we said earlier, you just can't mount it. Maybe you don't have a garage, like who knows what situation you're in. This is a really good solution. And there's really no limit on who it's for in terms of power capacity because the 43 kilowatt hours of battery that it can hold is more than the average home uses in a day. Overall, it just fits a lot of people's needs. So like we said, we will leave links in the description down below. Make sure you go down there and check it out. We'll leave any coupon codes that we can to help you guys save some money at Signature Solar. Otherwise, that is all we got for you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. We will catch you next time. Peace out and stay charged.